Hi, everybody. This is Judy Jones with the Public Library of Youngstown in Mahoning County. Today, I am going to give a brief overview on cover letters and why they're so important. Cover letters. Do you really need to write one? Yes, most likely yes. Some industries do not require them, such as the fast food industry or the restaurant industry, but many companies do require a cover letter. So what is a cover letter? A cover letter is a personal introduction of yourself and a statement of interest in the job position that you're applying for. It also expands upon your experiences and the skills that are related to the job that you are applying for. It also provides a sample of written communications. People like to see that you can articulate your thoughts well in writing, so a cover letter can do just that. It also differentiates yourself from other candidates. If you write a really good cover letter and you can make it stand out from your competition, the employer may be more inclined to call you in for a job interview. It communicates your strengths, your personalities. It's essentially a personal sales letter. The goal is to convince your reader to call you in for a job interview so that you can wow them with your personality in person. So before you write a cover letter, make sure you read the job posting really carefully, because you want to get a feel for the company culture and what they're really looking for. You also want to identify how your qualifications match what the employer is seeking. So make sure you do the research of a company as well. And the library can help you with this. We can show you or find annual reports for you, recent articles about the company, articles that were published recently by the companies as well. You can find out what the recent trends in the industry is. And again, peruse their website. That's really important because that will definitely give you a feel for what they're really looking for. Don't use pre-written or generic cover letters. I've had people ask me, can I go to Google or some other program and just copy and paste and use a cover letter that way? And I would tell you no. You really want your cover letter to be as unique as possible. You want to make sure it's written in your own words. You want it to tell your story and your story only. You can, of course, go to Google or other websites and look at generic cover letters and use them as guides to help you write one. But don't copy verbatim, because many employers are recognizing this today, and that wouldn't bode well for you if you copied and pasted someone else's work. Cover letters should contain the following elements: your name, your phone number, your email address, the date you're writing the cover letter, the salutation, "Dear Mr. Smith" or "Dear Hiring Manager." If you can find out who the hiring manager's name is, by all means, try to do it and use that. But I realize many times when you apply for a job, especially online, many names are not forthcoming or available. So "Dear Hiring Manager" is perfectly acceptable. Your open paragraph should state who you are and why you are writing. So, cover letters must contain the following elements. This is after your introductory paragraph. It must contain the main body of your letter. And this is where the meat of the cover letter is. This is where you need to shine and show them how wonderful you are. You also need to detail your unique skills in this part. You can explain why you are the ideal candidate. This is really where you want to brand and position yourself. You want to market yourself. And that's what a cover letter really is. It's a marketing document that highlights your accomplishments and how it relates to the company's specific needs. So when I say that, I mean most of your letters should be written to keep the company's needs in mind, to make sure that you are addressing the needs of the job position that they're looking for. So you have to position yourself as the solution. Another component would be the closing paragraph where you could ask for a job interview. And this is also where you could offer to follow up with a phone call or a letter of some kind or an email. But bear in mind that if you see on a job advertisement, no phone calls, if you see those words, then don't call them because they really mean that when they put that in a job advertisement. The closing could be sincerely, respectfully, warm regards, anything that sounds professional for you. And enclosures, of course, when we apply for jobs online today, we have enclosures such as the as references, job applications, and other backup documents such as letters of recommendation or anything that they might be asking for. So the next few slides, I am just going to show samples of cover letters. So this one, as you can see, there's the date at the top. There is the address of the hiring manager and the salutation, Dear Ms. Shrewsbury or hiring manager. And then you have your introductory paragraph. And then the next two paragraphs are your credentials. This is where you're trying to market yourself. You're trying to show them what skills you have that would pertain to the job that they're looking for. And you're also letting them know that you accomplished something at your past job. For example, the paragraph where you see increase our average dollar volume per sale by 27%, you're letting them know that you're competent and basically if they hire you, that this is probably something that you can help them with or help them improve their sales with or whatever the job contains. And then, of course, the last paragraph where you are letting them know that you would love to meet with them and for them to please contact you. And with the last closing section, sincerely, your name. You can at this point just put your name, address, phone number, email. You don't have to put your address. I know some people have an issue with that because of privacy. But you can certainly just put your name, your phone number, your email, and then an enclosure. I mean, you most likely will have a resume that will accompany this cover letter. So what you see before you is a talent match cover letter sample. I have worked with some people who have used this type of cover letter. So it has all the same elements I mentioned before, like your address, the manager's address, the salutation, Dear Mr. Richmond, today's date, and then the introductory paragraph. And then there's this table that you see where it gives a side-by-side match. It gives what they're looking for, the company requirements, and what your qualifications are. This is really good for people who want to change careers too and want to match their qualifications to what another company is looking for. So in this sample, they show you what they're looking for. They're looking for someone with 5 years of experience managing employees and corporate communication programs. And your qualifications state that you have 8 years of experience directing the ongoing communication effort with employees. Maybe you weren't doing something exactly what they were looking for, but it's close. So you can use a tactic that way in getting their attention. And of course, you have the closing paragraph with the closing salutation in your name, and you have the ENC period, which denotes enclosures with your documents. Here are many links that will give you a plethora of information on cover letter writing. If you want me to email these to you, I will be more than happy to do that. The next slide will detail my email address as well, but I would highly recommend that you go through these sites to get more in-depth information on how to write an effective and wonderful cover letter. Judy, that's me, is a certified career facilitator. I have worked with many patrons over the past few years, assisting them in writing effective resumes and cover letters. I've guided individuals through the online job application process, and I also help individuals register for Ohio Means Jobs. If you need assistance, please email me at jjjones@libraryvisit.org. You can also send me your resume. I can review it. Or if you have a cover letter or two that you want me to look over, I'll be more than happy to do that. If you prefer not to talk via email, you can definitely send me your phone number and I will call you back and we can talk in person. Thank you for watching.